वेलकम टू ईपीजी पाठशाला एंड दिस मॉड्यूल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ वाटर वी विल डिस्कस द वाटर इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट मटेरियल ऑन द अर्थ ड्यू टू इट्स यूनिक प्रॉपर्टीज वी विल डिस्कस द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ वाटर इन डिफरेंट स्पीयर्स वी विल डिवाइड दिस लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव्स इन फोर कैटेगरीज हाइड्रोलॉजिकल साइकिल दैट इज वाटर साइकिल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ वाटर यूनिक प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ वाटर एंड केमिकल कंपोजिशन ऑफ वाटर Now, hydrological cycle and water cycle. Hydrological cycle is related to the movement of water from the earth's surface through evaporation into the atmosphere. Its application is to model the storage and movement of water between different spheres such as the biosphere, atmosphere, lithosphere and hydrosphere. In environment, there are reservoirs which store water. The important reservoirs are ocean, lakes, rivers, glaciers, soils, snowfields and groundwater on the earth. It is found in liquid, solid or vapor and gases. It is interesting to point out that no beginning or end can be assigned to hydrological cycle. Now, this hydrological cycle, the study of hydrological cycle involves an understanding of the evaporation, condensation, precipitation, interruption, infiltration, percolation, transpiration, runoff and storage processes. Now, we will discuss evaporation. When the physical state of water changes from liquid state to vapor state, the process is called evaporation. The natural evaporation is affected by the external factors such as solar radiation, atmospheric temperature, vapor pressure, wind and atmospheric pressure. It is also affected by surface area and amount of water. Now, condensation. When the water vapors change into a liquid state, the process is called condensation. Water vapor condenses onto small airborne particles to form dew, fog or clouds. Condensation occurs when either the water vapor bearing air cools or the amount of water vapors in the air reaches its saturation point. Now, precipitation. Precipitation of water refers to the release of water from clouds in the form of rain, freezing rain, sleet, snow or hail. It leads to the delivery of atmospheric water to the earth. It is the process that occurs of water particles fall from the atmosphere and reach the ground. Precipitated water may fall into a water body or onto land. It is then dispersed in several ways. Now, percolation. Percolation is the movement of water through the soil and its layers by gravity and capillary forces. The prime moving force of groundwater is gravity. Now, transpiration. Transpiration is basically evaporation of water from plant leaves. In this process, moisture is carried through plants from roots to small pores on the underside of leaves, where it changes to vapor and is released to the atmosphere. Now, this is we will discuss the hydrological cycle. The water from ocean, in presence of solar energy, it evaporates to the atmosphere. And the plants also evaporate transpiration during day time presence of solar energy, and the wind percolate this precipitation and condensation after in form of ice or rain, and then it run off to the lakes and streams, and some water infiltration and deep percolation, and again they through the plant streams and runoff the water comes again in ocean, and this is chain continue, and this is known as hydrological cycle. Now, distribution of water. The most common liquid on our planet is water. It is vital to all life forms. Water is widely distributed on earth as fresh water and salt water in the ocean. A fresh water ecosystem is an aquatic ecosystem with a low salt concentration. It includes lakes, ponds, springs, rivers, streams and wetlands. These are of two types, the lentic or still water ecosystem and the aiotic or the flowing water ecosystem. Lakes and ponds belong to the lentic ecosystem. These bodies can be small or huge. Streams and rivers are bodies of flowing water. The water from the aiotic ecosystem originates from springs, melted snow in the mountains and even lakes. Now, this table shows the distribution of water. Water sources. Water volume in cubic miles, water volume in cubic kilometers, and percent of fresh water and percent of total water. Now, ocean, seas and bays, this have 3210000000 and water volume 1338000000. Percent of fresh water is nil and the percent of total water is 96.5. Now, ice caps, glaciers and permanent snow, they are having percent of fresh water 68.6 and percent of total water is 1.74. Ground water, this again the percent of fresh water is nil and the percent of total water is 1.7. Fresh 2.526000000 in water volume in cubic miles and 2.3400000000 in cubic kilometer. This again percent of fresh water is 30.1 and total percent of total water is 0.76. In saline, the percent of fresh water nil and it is 0.93 in percent of total water. Now, solid moisture, it is 3959 in cubic meters and 1.65000000 in cubic kilometers. It has the percent of fresh water is 0.05 and total water is 0.001. Ground ice and permafrost, it is 71970 and 3000000. It has percentage of fresh water 0.86 and 0.022 is total percent of total water. In a similar manner, we can discuss the percentage of lakes. It is nil in percent of fresh water and 0.013 in percent of total water. Fresh water, again it is 0.26 in percentage of fresh water and 0.007 in percent of total water. Now, saline, it is again percentage of fresh water nil and 0.007 in total water. Now, atmosphere, it is water volume in cubic meter is 3095 and in kilometer it is 12900. It has value of 0.04% of fresh water and 0.001 in total water. Now, swamp water, it is the value comes to fresh water 0.03 and 0.0008 is percentage of total water. Now, rivers, the value is 0.006 of fresh water and 0.0002 and percentage of total water. And lastly, the biological water, it has a percentage of fresh water is 0.003 and 0.0001 is percentage of total water. Now, chemical composition of water. Water has chemical formula H2O. Water is composed of one atom of oxygen with two atom of hydrogen. Water is a polar molecule with oxygen having a partial negative charge and each hydrogen atom having partial positive charge. Water is a tasteless, odorless liquid and appears colorless in small quantities. The composition of seawater, river water, lake water and groundwater is given in table 2, 3 and 4. Sea water contains mainly sodium ion and colloid ion and river water contains mainly calcium ion and hydroconium ion. Now, this table shows the composition of sea water and river water in millimoles kilo inverse. Elements are just sodium, the value is in sea water 468 and river water 0.26. In a similar manner, the magnesium 53.1 and 0.17, calcium 10.3 and 0.38, potassium 10.2.07, strontium 0.09 and nil, chloride 546 and 0.22, sulfate 28.2.11, SO3 2.39 and 0.96 and bromium 0.84 and nil. This table show pH and concentration ranges of the ions milligram liter inverse in groundwater. Here parameters like calcium, the range is 200 to 240. Magnesium ion 58.3 to 87.5, sodium ion 28 to 35, potassium ion 3.7 to 4.7, SCO3 minus 150 to 298, chloride ion 188.9 to 212, fluoride ion less than 0.5, nitrate ion 330 to 400, sulfate ion 103 to 220, copper 0.01 to 0.04, lead less than 0.1, zinc 0.60 to 1.30, iron 0.33 to 1.12, manganese 0.01 to 0.03, and this pH is 736 to 7.80. This table show pH and concentration range of the ions milligram liter inverse in lake water. Again, the different parameters show the range is like calcium 241, magnesium 7200, sodium 83600, potassium 4070, bicarbonate 251, sulfate 16400, chloride 14000, silica 48, TDS 25400, and pH is 7.4. Now, unique properties of water. Water is one of the God's gift to mankind. It is the only abundant, common, pure compound which is a liquid. The earth appears to be a majestic blue marble from top. This is due to the abundance of water on the earth's surface. Water makes up about 71% of the earth's surface, while the other 29% consist of continents and islands. 96.5% of all the earth's water is contained within the ocean as salt water, while the remaining 3.5% is fresh water lakes and frozen water locked up in glacier and the polar ice caps. Now, the fresh water, almost all of it takes the form of ice, that is 69% of it. Water is the clear sparkling fluid which covers 3/4 of the earth's surface. Water is the possessor of the world's most recognizable chemical formula, H2O. Water molecules are attracted to each other and form hydrogen bonds. A large part of the mass of most organisms is simply water. In human tissues, the percentage of water ranges from 20% in bones to 85% in brain cells. About 70% of our total body weight is water. Now, water, the universal solvent. Water has the ability to dissolve most of the substances. Some have high solubility, whereas some are only springly soluble. It is therefore called a universal solvent. In rainwater, the substance and atmospheric gases present in air get dissolved. Now, this table shows physical properties of water. Molar mass, the value is 18.015, molar volume 55.5 moles per liter, boiling point 100 degree centigrade at 1 atmosphere, freezing point 0 degree centigrade at 1 atmosphere, triple point 27.3.16 K at 4.6 torr, surface tension 73 dynes at 20 degree centigrade, vapor pressure 0.0212 atmosphere at 20 degree centigrade, heat of vaporization 40.63 kilojoule per mole, heat of fusion 6.013 kilojoule per mole, heat capacity 4.22 kilojoule per kg K, dielectric constant 78.54 at 25 degree centigrade, viscosity 1.002 centipoise at 20 degree centigrade, density is 1 gram per cc and density maxima is 4 degree centigrade. In this module, properties of water, we have learned the properties of water. Water is a unique solvent. We learned the different parameters about water and different of different ions involved in this hydrological cycle. Thank you.